Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Animal Crossing New Horizons. Thank you, everybody. This is the follow-up video that we did from yesterday's video. So as you can see, I'm still on that mystery island that we had from yesterday, but everything has been completely cleared out, save for the buds of the wildflowers, because those don't apparently affect any of the spawns. I have found out, though, thanks to people here on the in the Twitch Mosh Pit, that there is a new bug that I was not aware of called the Mole Cricket, which actually do affect the spawns of the bugs, but I feel like it's not that big of a deal because there's always going to be one. Basically, what you do is you have to find them like you would any mole cricket in the real world. Just dig them out, and then they just despawns. That's it. But one almost always instantaneously comes back. So, but as you can see here, I also have removed those two coconut trees that were spawning the Atlas Moths. I actually ran out of my axe. It broke before I could remove the last two coconut trees here, so I decided to just remove them and temporarily place them in my inventory for now, and we'll get rid of them whenever we can or want to. So now we should only be getting four types of bugs. We should be getting tarantulas, wharf roaches, tiger beetles, and mole crickets. And those are essentially the only bugs that can spawn on this map now. And this should be a pretty big money getter here. So those are three tiger beetles right there. You have noticed that I've piled up a bunch of garbage over here on the right side of the map. And that's just to simply get them out of my inventory. Obviously, we can't sell them to anybody here. And yeah, let's just see how it goes. And if this ends up working, I'll explain the process either way. But essentially, we got ourselves almost a perfect island to do this with, because we got a mystery island that doesn't have any... We don't have an island that has any water on it at all, so like no rivers, no lakes, nothing like that, which means that there's more surface area for the bugs to spawn at, and it should make this fairly easy. Now, as you could just plainly see, of course, if you end up moving too fast or you startle the tarantula, they will actually incapacitate you, but because we're on a very, very small island and we have manipulated the spawns to the way that we have right now, it's not that big of a deal. We just simply go out there and just go get them. So that's what happens when you miss a tarantula. This is what happens when you catch one. You get 8,000 bells in the bank, and you can bet your bottom dollar, you can bet your bottom bell that we're going to have this filled with tarantulas. Now, I was also content with just doing Atlas Moths, but we figured it out that the Atlas Moths were actually heavily influencing and preventing the tarantulas from spawning. And I've also found out... Also have found out that they only sell for 3,000 bells, not 4,000. So by that logic, it doesn't really make a whole lot of sense to put a lot of effort into catching the Atlas Moths, especially when they're so finicky, when the tarantulas are just so easy to catch. I mean, you know, it takes you 30 seconds and you got yourself another 8 G's in the bank. So that's what we're going to be doing here, and let's just see how much we get. One thing I will say is that I'm looking forward to I don't even know how many free inventory spaces do we have. Let's see, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have 40 spaces total, and not counting the tools that we've got, or counting the tools that we have 2, 4, 6, 7, 9. So we got 30. We have places for 31 tarantulas. And then two more after I put the palm trees down. Because I am going to keep... I'm keeping one Atlas Moth for my museum. And then the other one I'm keeping for my house. Because I think that they are cool looking. And yes, we did just scare that tarantula... Not tarantula, but the tiger beetle into the water. Always feels good. Apparently, the tarantulas will also just yeet themselves into the water. I don't think anyone knew that. So let that be a lesson to those of you out there who are doing the tarantula hunting. They can and will just completely yeet themselves right into the ocean. It's good to know. I go through this so you all don't have to. This is a How to Farm Tarantulas 101 with Synvicta in Animal Crossing New Horizons. Now you can hear all the mole crickets there, and it sounds like we have two of them, and that's fine. As long as we don't get like as long as they don't get out of control, I don't mind having two there. It does limit the tarantula spawn somewhat, but the mole crickets can just keep spawning over and over again. There's not really much you can do about them. It is kind of annoying though that they do show up underground. I've always heard the crickets, but like I never knew that. I thought it was just an ambient sound effect. I didn't know that you could actually dig them up until now. There we go. This is no problem at all. I have to sprint over here to get rid of all the wharf roaches, because they do count as an insect spawn. We're going to be seeing quite a lot of tiger beetles. There's a mole cricket somewhere over here. We have to assume that the... I thought for sure that the items that I placed on the rocks would stop the mole... stop the wharf roaches from spawning, but apparently they don't. He didn't turn around. You got to make a full 180 there, bro. But the one tarantula that works on, we are going to style all over him. Watch this. What's up, bros? This is Chad Victa here, back with another Animal Crossing tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to completely beta these tarantulas. Alright, first thing you got to do, you got to find a tarantula. Next, you got to alarm it. After you alarm it, you start sprinting as fast as you can, get your cardio in, take it around for a couple trips around the island just to show them that you're in charge. Now make sure you have your bug net out, because it's going to be quite essential whenever you're ready to pounce. When you have enough distance, you turn around, and you can totally beta him. This has been brought to you by Chad Victa. Make sure you smash the like button, bros. And subscribe and leave a comment down below for more Animal Crossing New Horizon tutorials. Is going to be a ton of money. Now, I'm not saying that this entire video is going to be filled with me just running around and completely destroying tarantulas, but it may be. I may be here a while. So now is a great time to talk about other things that I like about Animal Crossing, because we have a whole lot of tarantulas to catch, and this could take a while, like I said. I really love the music. I love the sound design. I love the art style. I'm not a huge fan of the whole like red nose thing. I could do without that. But for the most part, I mean, everything about the game is just appealing in all kinds of ways. I do think that the clash in styles in terms of like the realistic portrayals of the animals is interesting. You wouldn't expect that. Sneak attack! But it gives us this really neat, like, sort of, like, mashup of stylized art and also realistic animals. And because the seasons have changed now, or at least the month has changed, there's always going to be a host of new animals and stuff that you can get for your island. And I'm wondering, I don't know, because again, this is the first time I've ever played Animal Crossing. This is my literal first Animal Crossing game that I've ever played. I don't know how often Nintendo like delivers updates for Animal Crossing like in previous games. Like, I don't know if they're going to add more and more animals. I don't know if they're going to add, like, you know, better tools, or obviously they're going to keep adding like cosmetic stuff and also like furniture and whatnot, but I don't know if they're going to add more animals. It seems like that they have like the infrastructure planned out with the whole museum thing, that they would. It would make sense to. You just gotta keep them frozen. Frozen with fear. Situation got hairy, not for us. For one of us. But it ain't me. Also, the eggs from the Easter event also remind me of the eggs that you used to get in Monster Hunter Stories. Which I'm still hoping actually gets released for the Switch and maybe even a sequel, question mark. I mean, if they released it for mobile, they should release it for the Switch. Just give us a sequel. Monster Hunter Stories is one of my favorite games ever. Especially being a huge fan of the Monster Hunter series, of course. What would really, really be awesome is to get a Monster Hunter crossover event with Animal Crossing. How great would that be? I would be all over that. Magic the Gathering, they just announced it was leaked, and then of course it was officially announced that they've got a new set coming out that does a Godzilla crossover. And you know your boy's going to be all over that. I mean, I've already, the money that I have imagined out for the budget for buying like tons and tons of boxes of that set is already out the door. Like, I'm ready to go for that. I love the crossover events, and I think that Monster Hunter would actually work quite well with the Animal Crossing. I'm not talking about like combat and stuff. I'm just saying it would be neat to catch like a wild, I don't know, like a mini like Rathalos, or like to make a Rathalos statue or something like that, or maybe even the armor. I think the armor would be awesome. People would love to see that. I would love to see that Animal Crossing. And because of how connected the game is with everything, and because like they've got this whole like social network built up with the Switch and with everything being sync to real time, especially like from geographical details and that sort of thing, you could really do a whole lot with this game. The future for Animal Crossing is definitely exciting. As someone who's only played, like, I've got maybe, I have no idea how many hours I have in the game. It's probably like, I would say approaching 30 to 40 maybe. I'm really, really interested to see what else they do with this game. We are rocking and rolling with these tarantulas. Look at this. Oh, man, that's beautiful. I mean, it's not beautiful. It's quite horrifying, actually. But it's money in the bank. And you know what? For 8,000 bucks, for 8,000 per, I'm totally, totally down for this. And I think that if you find yourself with a good island like this, and you're playing at nighttime, of course, tarantulas only spawn at night. I don't know if they're hemisphere specific, though. I assume that they are, but don't quote me on that. That's something that you could probably easily Google. I would highly recommend doing this, because if, just hypothetically speaking, let's say we got 40 tarantulas, right? And they're all selling for $8,000 a pop. That's like 300 and, that's like what, 320K? That is a ton of money. You hear the mole crickets. We don't care about the tiger beetles. I would actually, in real life, because Twitch chat has been pondering this, I would actually be more terrified of a tiger beetle. So many tiger beetles than a tarantula. If I saw a tarantula in real life, it would not be a pleasant time. But I wouldn't just immediately, like retch and faint, you know. Tarantulas would definitely be startling, but once you realize that tarantulas, like, they really try hard to stay away from humans, not that bad. As opposed to, like, a roach, or, like, say, a giant locust that's sitting on my shoe that wouldn't let me go into my apartment that one night that I threw my other shoe at, and then it totally just said, well, no, this is my shoe now, too. It was horrible. But I've already told that story. That story is, like, many, many Isaac episodes in. I missed. The streak is over. You can't get too close to the tarantulas. Don't worry, Wilbur. I'm fine. So yeah. So anyway, now that I've, this video length is good enough. You guys and gals get the idea. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to finish off catching all of the tarantulas here and filling up my bags. That way you all don't have to watch it. But at least I can confidently confirm that you can still farm tarantulas. People were saying that with the recent release or the recent patch, it was making it harder. Obviously, it's not the case because we got ourselves a perfect island here. But I'm going to catch this tarantula, and then I'll send you on your way. And then, of course, the next episode, I'll go ahead and show you all how much we make before I sell them. That way, you all can get a good idea of how much money this actually is worth. So thank you all very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, I know it wasn't that informative, but hey, if you got something out of it or if you maybe learned something you didn't know, definitely click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Let me know what kind of islands you like to see and what was your favorite island. What was your favorite mystery island that you found so far in Animal Crossing New Horizons? And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!